Hello everybody and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today we're going to be creating BB8 in Blender. As you can see in the render on screen right now, I'm going to be showing you how to model BB8, I'm going to show you how to texture it, and then finally render it out. Let's first start off by going to the modifier section and go add modifier, subdivision surface. I should also turn on my screencast keys for you guys, there you go. Okay, so with the subdivision surface, we're going to turn all the views and the render to 6. Now, the reason we're using a cube instead of like a UV sphere is because it'll be a lot easier to UV unwrap later. I've already created a texture for the UV map, so all you have to do is go into edit mode, click U, and smart UV projection. But don't worry about that right now. In this video, we're going to be actually just modeling. So once you've done that, click smooth shading on the toolbar, and then you can press T to close that off. Okay, so go into front view and then press 5 to go into orthographic view. Now, it would be kind of hard to model it by hand without a reference image, so all you have to do is go to Google and type in BB8 blueprint and you'll find all these different images that you can use. I personally like this one right here, I think it looks pretty good. So you can just right click, save image as, and then open it up in a background image in Blender. So over here, you can press N and open up the properties panel, scroll down to background images, check that box, and then go add image. Click open and then navigate to where you saved it at. Mine is right here, this one. Once you've done that, we can now start modeling and positioning. So I'm gonna move the cube over here and then scale it up. Probably around there looks pretty good. All right, so once we've done that, we can now start modeling the head. You can also press N to close off that panel so we have a little bit more room. Press Shift A, we're going to add in a mesh and then UV sphere. Delete half of this UV sphere by going into edit mode. Make sure you're in wireframe by pressing Z. Press A to deselect everything and then box select this bottom bit and then press X, vertices. Once you've done that, we can now position it. So move it over here into place, scale it down a little bit, and then position it right around here. Oh, right there looks good. Now what we need to do is scale it along the X and the Y, but not the Z. To do this, you can press S, Shift, Z, and that will go along the two axis, just like that. And then maybe along the Z as well, just a tiny bit, and then drag it up. Right around there looks pretty good. You can go into edit mode, box select that part, press S and just scale it inwards. Maybe scale the whole thing down just a tiny bit. You just want to get it roughly the size, it doesn't really matter because it's not too noticeable, but probably around there looks good. Then you can kind of take a step back and look at it. That looks decent. All right, let's go back into edit mode. Now with this bottom vertice row selected, you can press E to extrude and then Z and bring it down. Then you can go into wireframe and scale it inwards until it's like the size of this bottom bit right here on the reference image. So probably around there looks good. Maybe I'll drag it up. Then you can press F to fill in a face. Perfect. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Let's add in a subdivision surface to smooth out the head. So go add modifier, subdivision surface, not solidify, subdivision surface, and you can bring both of these up to 2. Hit smooth shading on that as well, then go into edit mode. I want this row to be a little bit sharper, so I'm gonna hit Control R, add a loop cut right here and drag it up. Then I'll add a loop cut on this part and drag this down. So if we go out of edit mode, you can see that that's now a sharp edge. I think this one is a little too close, so I'll drag that back. There we go, that looks good. And then I'll just go one more loop cut and drag that in so this edge is now sharp. Perfect, let's go into front view and see how that looks. Not too bad. What I might do is go into edit mode on it and just scale out these rows of vertices just so it's a little bit more round. So you can alt right click on any row and that will grab the loop. So I'll alt right click on this one and just scale it out just a tiny bit. Maybe I'll do the same for this one, just scale it out just a tiny bit. Maybe this one up here. There we go, I think that looks just a little bit better. Perfect. All right, so we have the head and now the body. Let's do the antennas and then at the end we'll focus on the eyes and then this little like knob sort of thing. So for the antenna, it looks like this one is a cylinder and then this one is a cube. So we'll do that. Let's click right here, press Shift A, we'll go to mesh and then cylinder. I'll scale this down. I'll probably position it right around here, and then I'll scale it along the z-axis until it's the right size. There we go. Go into edit mode, I'll select that top bit, extrude by hitting E, right click, and scale out. Then I'll extrude one more time. There we go. I might want to scale this a little bit down so it's more defined, so I'll just alt right click that, S, shift to Z, and scale that inwards. There we go, that looks pretty good. For this one, I'm gonna be using a cube, so just press shift A, we'll go to mesh, and then cube. Scale that down, and then position it right where you want it to be, so probably here. Scale it along the Z, right there, and make sure this part is down, so it's like inside the head. Then right click on this face, extrude, right click, and scale inwards, and then extrude up. Then at the top, you can just bevel it out, so hit Control B, and drag it down a little bit. Oh, drag it down right around there. And if you use the scroll wheel, you can smooth it out. So there we go. That looks good right there. Not too bad. Now for this, it looked like there was like some sort of face in between this, kind of like inside it. So how I'm going to do that is alt right click here. And if you hit the I key, that will inset the face. But if you only hit it once, it's just insetting all of them together. If you do it twice, hit I twice, it'll inset the faces individually. So there we go. Let's bring that in, probably around there. That looks good. Now let's extrude it inwards. So press E, then right click, then press S, shift to Z, and scale that in. Look at that. We got some detail in. That looks pretty good. Now let's position it. So go into side view by hitting 3 on your number pad. And if we look at this view right here, it looks like this one is further back and this one's probably right in the middle between the edge and then the middle. So I'll right click on this and I'll drag it back till it's about the length. That's probably good right there, maybe a little closer here. Then go into edit mode, right click on this bottom face and drag it inside the head. Then right click on this other antenna and drag it back. Probably around there looks good. Yeah, maybe this one a little further back this way. Yeah, that's fine right there. It's not going to be too noticeable, so don't even worry about it. But there we go. That looks pretty good, I would say. Now, for the eye, what we're going to be doing is adding in a UV sphere. So press Shift A, go to Mesh, and then UV sphere. I'll position it over here, then I'm going to delete half of it. So go into edit mode, press Z, and then box select the bottom bit and press X and go faces. Next, add in a circle. So press Shift A, go to mesh and then circle. Position it right here. Scale it out maybe. Probably around there looks good. Go into edit mode and make sure you're in vertices. If you try to extrude with face mode selected, it's not gonna work. Like I try to extrude, it doesn't do anything. So make sure you're in vertices select mode, then press E and extrude out. Now before we go any more, let's position it into place so we can actually see the size and everything. So I'll scale this down, I'll rotate it this way, I'll position it probably around here. We'll use this reference image right here, this third one. And I'll scale it down, rotate it up, probably around there, looks good. Yeah, and then you can right click on the UV sphere and just drag it back a little bit more. Scale it up maybe. Alright, so for this part right here, this circle, what we're going to do is select this top bit right here, deselect the bottom, and then go extrude. So extrude that out. Next, box select these two vertices right here, you can see those two. Then go into front view again, and press G, and then position it at this angle. So it's like that. Maybe right there looks pretty good. So we have this sort of small detail in it, that looks good. Next, I'm going to grab... Let's go into edge select mode and we'll just grab a couple edges right here. So this one and this one, I'll grab this one and this one. I'm skipping every other one. I'll grab this one and that one and these two at the end. Hit extrude and then Z twice so it locks it to the normal Z axis and I'll just drag it right there. Perfect. There we go. We got some detail into this part now. But it looks pretty bad because it's completely flat. So let's add in a solidify modifier. So go add modifier and solidify. I'll drag the thickness up. Oh wait, that's not the thickness. This is the thickness. I'll drag it out this way and then I'll set the offset to 1. So it actually goes inwards instead of out. because if the offset is set to -1, you can see it's going out and this is going in. So I want it to go in. Next, hit smooth shading on this outer guard or whatever it is, then go add modifier right here and edge split. This will just make it look a lot nicer. Then add a subdivision surface to the eye. So go add a modifier, subdivision surface. We can change both the view and the render to 2, and then we'll hit smooth shading. Let's take a look at that. That looks pretty good. Let's go into front view again. Make sure everything looks good. We'll move it out of the way. Yep, that looks pretty good. Now let's position it. So go into top view by hitting 7, and let's position it right in front right here. You can hit R, and if you hold control, you can look at the bottom left corner. You can see it's going in increments of 5. That is what control does. If I let it go, it just goes like that. So I'll hold control and go 90 degrees. Then I'll position it inside. So I'll position it right there. You can go into front view and look at the reference image and kind of position it like that. So it looks like it's right there. Go into side view and then drag it inwards. Maybe rotate it this way a little bit. Let's take a look at that. That looks pretty good. I want it to be a little lower though, so what I'll do is I'll grab both of these, rotate it this way, and drag it down just a tad. Let's take a look at that. There we go, we got the eye. Let's press Shift Z to see how it looks. Not too bad. The next thing that we're going to be modeling is this little knob or turn thing, kind of looks like a volume thing. So let's press Shift A, we'll go to Mesh and then Circle. Let's position it over here and scale it down. So for this, let's just go into edit mode with vertices select mode on. I'll scale it down a little bit more. I'll zoom in on that as well. Okay, so let's extrude, right click, and scale inwards. And then we'll drag it down. Because as you can see in the front view, it kind of looks like it goes inwards just a little bit maybe. And so from here, we'll go extrude along the Z. Well, maybe not, that's a little high. And then I'll drag it inwards. Let's take a look at the reference image one more time. So then it goes out and then it goes back in kind of. So from here, we'll go extrude, we'll scale it out. We're right here now. Then I will go extrude, Z, and scale inwards. And I'll just round off this top bit. So scale, Z, and scale just like this, just rounding it out. And then at the end, I'll press F. There we go, that's not too bad. Then for this edge right here, I'm gonna alt right click it and then go extrude Z and just drag it down so it looks good. But currently the normals are totally messed up, so we'll go into edit mode, select everything, and go control N, and that will flip the normals and make them look good. Now if we zoom in on this knob, you can see that there's little small indents right here, kind of that's what they look like. So an easy way to do that is go into edit mode, make sure you're in face select mode, alt right click this edge loop, hit I twice like we did before, scale it inwards, and then you can hit extrude and right click. Then press S, Shift Z, and scale it out. There we go, we got this small amount of detail and I think it looks pretty good. Let's look at the thing right here. Yep, everything else looks good. We'll go smooth shading on that, smooth shading, and then we'll add in a edge split. So go edge split. And there we go, we got our little knob. Perfect. Let's go into front view and then position it over here. So right click on that, move it over this way, and rotate it like that. You can double tap R to give it this sort of rotation, a free rotation sort of thing. Scale it down, and then position it just like that. Go into top view and then drag it through. Rotate this way a little bit. Let's take a look. Not too bad, kind of looks like it needs to rotate this way though. It's kind of hard to rotate and position things when it's on a UV sphere, but just try your best, look at different angles, just like that, rotate along the Z a little bit. There we go, and it kind of looks like this is a little tall, so what I'll do is I'll box select this part, deselect that, deselect, there we go, press G, Z, Z, and just drag that back, just a tiny bit. Yeah, I think that looks a little bit better. Let's take a step back and look at it. There we go, not too bad. I'll save that by hitting Control S. I'll save it to my desktop. I'll just call it BB8 tutorial. There we go. Let's press Shift Z. Not too bad. That looks pretty good. So that is it for this part. Thank you for watching. And in the next part, we will texture and give the materials and do some rendering. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next part.